So we've got four presentations now, so thank you very much to our four presenters for volunteering to talk about what they've been doing with Mahara. So we start off with Lillian, and we're going to move on to Louise, then Gordon, and then Teresa, but I'll let them sort of introduce themselves as and when we go. Okay, so over to you. Good luck.
Yeah, okay, thank you. I will just switch off my my camera just to give the opportunity to have the presentation in a bigger size. Okay for me. Then let's start. So hi everyone, I'm Lilian Hugues and I'm a pedagogical engineer and a co-founder of ETCO. Two things before starting. First, I'd like to really thank the Catalyst team for having invited me and given me the opportunity to share our work on Mahara. And second, I want to apologize in advance for my horrible English. I hope you will understand what I say despite my language mistakes. So my presentation will show you how ETCO has created a professional social network based on a multi-institution Mahara platform. Each new institution has its own request of on using the social network, and ETCO has been working for over 8 years to tweak Mahara for each new institution. And I'll show you a brief overview of what we have done through three examples. Let me introduce ETCO before starting, just to give you the context we work into. ETCO has been created in 2011, and we provide pedagogical engineering services for French-speaking healthcare community. Most of our services are about creating Moodle platform or creating content into this Moodle platform and courses for our customers. Our customers are working in the world of healthcare. It can be manufacturer or software editor, public or private hospital, and school, university, and scientific society. And one of our main activities deal with Mahara, of course. This is the purpose of today. And our work on Mahara is with a platform called Medzone. So what is Medzone? Medzone is a social network dedicated for French-speaking healthcare community. This network is based on a unique Mahara on the 1904 version, configured on a multi-institution non-partition. We have the default Medzone open for free for each medical professional individually. And each user can also access to Medzone and also to the campus of Medzone, which is actually LMS based on a Moodle. The two environments are connected with SSO, ETCO SSO, based on OIDC authentication plugin. And our activity is to configure for each institutional customer a private institution. A new institution means possibly another way of authenticating through another ID provider, CAS, Shibboleth, Auth0, etc. And each institution can access to the campus of Medzone and can access to its own LMS. Actually, most often it's another Moodle, but it can be another LMS engine. We can adapt ourselves to connect to this LMS. And sometimes the institution may need to have access to an external tool, their own tool, like CRM, for example. And for us, a new institution on the networks means new tools, new way of using Mahara, new plugin, etc., new user experiences, new user interfaces. We impose ourselves some constraints. First is the choice of having only one instance of Mahara, to only have one community at the end. On this Mahara, we need to have multiple organizations, so multiple institutions. And these organizations are not completely partitioned because one final user can be part of more than one organization, and we need to give him the ability to switch from one institution to another. Each institution has its own use of Mara, as I said, his own way of connecting, his own design, his own needs in terms of functionalities. Thus, one specific user experience means one specific user interface. And as we don't really want to completely fork Mara, we need to remain based on the Mara core. We need to never change the Mara core in order to be able to easily upgrade version with Mara. So we're only working on plugin and on themes. And I will show you three examples. And I will switch to the real world and not the PowerPoint. The first example is the default theme of Medzone. I will explain you the homepage customization, the three steps of page creation, and the plugin to switch from one institution to another if I'm a user with enrolled on several institutions. And I will show you two other examples. The examples of Mediafolio. It's for the UNES customer. UNES is the digital university for French healthcare learners. It is about 150K students. And I will show you through this example the new way of navigating. And a huge modifications that we have made is to merge in one place the files and the page. And we'll show you another kind of pages. This is the CV page. It's another view type. And at the end, I will show you the Canon Medical Digital User Club, just to show you another way of navigating and the customization of the dashboard. So let's jump to the real world. I will show you it. So here, I'm on the Medzone interface. This is, oops, excuse me. This is the Medzone interface. Sorry, it's in the interface in French, but I will explain you what I'm showing to you. Here, this is the non-logged user page of Mara. So if we see the page of the Medzone, and if I want to connect, I just have to log in. I will take the demo user. So I'm logged as the default user. This is the default interface of Medzone, of our Mara. What we have done here, we have created a micro dashboard. So micro dashboard shows the picture of the user, his name, his job, the percentage completion of his profile, and the number of group he's part of, 7 group. He has created 42 pages. He has only one page shared with him individually. It's a demo user, that's normal. And he have 72 pages shared with the group he's part of. This is a small dashboard just to engage, to involve user, to create more pages, to share more things through groups, etc. On the right side, we can see here the different group the user is part of. He can enter a group directly by clicking here. And I will show you here the way of creating pages we have made in this version of Mara. I know the last version of Mara offer a more ergonomic way of creating pages, but on this version, we have made some changes. So here we have the menu. We have rebuilt the menu to sort activities through something more with more sense for us. So I will just show you how to create page. You know the system. You know all of the pages. We have the pages of the user and the page shared with the user through groups and directly. I just will just have one page. And our page creating in three steps: parameters, modify, and share. So here you can just change disposition, for example, and I will go to the next step. And next step here, you can create the page. Okay, I will go it very quickly because you know already this system. Okay, and here we can go to the next step to share it, or I can show the page, or go back to the page and collection. This is some buttons that we have added because the navigation was not so easy for our user, and we want to give them more indication of where they are on the process. And there I can go to the share, etc. I will go back to the homepage of this user just to show you that this user is part of several institutions, and you can switch to an institution to another. So here we can see a link to the campus. So if I open it, it directly connects to the campus. I don't need to disconnect and reconnect. And this is the campus of Medzone. And if I change the institution, I will switch to another institution. And in one click, I have changed the institution. I have the same user. That it means that here I have the same indicators, but the institution we can through the institution we can manage the percentage of completion of the profile. It means that the completion is roughly different regarding the previous one. And on the previous institution, the default, I just had access to Campus Medzone, and now I have access to another platform. This is the institution platform of Emotech, and I can go back to the institution. So through the institution, the user can access to one LMS or another. If you remember the presentation I've made here, one institution can go to the campus, and another institution can go to a campus, and also the specific LMS. Okay, this is only the things that I wanted to show you through this user. I will switch off and disconnect and connect to with a different user, just to show you another institution, another user. Another way of using Mara. This is always the same. This is always the same platform. This is always Medzone. Only the same. Always the same Mara platform. I have here the other example. This is Mediafolio. Mediafolio is for the French learners of healthcare in France, and they wanted to arrive directly in the group page, not in the dashboard of the user. So you see the theme is completely different. As soon as I'm logged, I arrive directly in groups, and I can find some groups. And sorry, there is a lot of groups. I wanted to show you two kind of group. Okay, not in this profile. We have, oops. Sorry, we have different groups. We have groups personal, we have group institutionals. Institutional groups allow user to give assessments and to be corrected by teacher, for example. And what we have done, especially for this this customer, we have merged documents, all the files, and all the pages into one place in order to have the habit, the use of, for example, Google Drive. On Google Drive, you have your personal files, your PPT, your PDF, and you have also in the same place the Google documents. Here, this is the same way of thinking. We have merged into one place the page of Mara and the file into MyMara. It means that we have merged two different things, what Mara called view and what Mara called artifacts. And merge into one thing, this is the third challenge. As the second challenge was to give the ability to put pages in folder, because in Mara, views are not created to be put in folder. So here we have changed the functions of Mara, always with plugin and not moving the core, to give the possibility for views to be put in folder and subfolder if we need. And we give also the possibility to sort it by date, by author, by name, and for each, if we have folder, if we have pages, and for each stuff, we can have action here. And for example, here I can open, modify, delete, and share directly with the action menu. And so we have now only three tabs, my documents, documents that I have shared, and documents shared with me. And on each, this is the same way of presenting the thing, and I can always act on it. For example, if I go back to my document, here it's not a page, it's only a picture, for example. I have no share, because we cannot share pictures, we just share pages through Mara. So I can just open, modify, delete, and download. Okay. The action button will change according of what I'm able to do with this this artifact or this page. And on this for this customer, we have created another thing, is the possibility for create CVs. So we have create a new view type. You know, you have several type of pages of view. So you have a dashboard. This is what the customer, the user see when he log in. The profile, it is what users see when they click on the name of the user. Group, homepage, and portfolio. And we have added here a new view type. This is CV, because they wanted to be able to create CV. So here we have a field that we things that we can manage through the CV. This is Mara functionalities, introduction, historical of employee, etc., result, etc., etc. So I can add information, and here I can create a CV. It is roughly the same thing of creating pages, portfolio pages, but here it's a view type CV. So it's not I don't have these pages in my document. It's only in my CVs, and it gives the opportunity for user to create their own CV and to share it as they want. And this customer, we have implement also the change, the merging of view and artifacts. At the personal level, we have moved it also in the group level. For example, I will just open one with some discussion. This one, for example. Okay. And when I go to content, here also I have merge file and view. Okay. So it was for the second customer. I will show you the last one, and after we will have some time to share and discuss. I will switch to another customer, but here I don't have the switch module because they don't want it. The switch module to switch to another institution, so I will use through preferences. I have access to this menu because I am the administrator, but final user cannot switch easily like it because we have blocked it. So here we are on the Canon Medical System France on the Digital Users Club. So we have changed completely the way of navigating, working on what the customer wants to do with customers, with users. So he wanted to give an accent of a focus on the events. And here we have the event, here we have the last information. It's directly linked to the blog, to the journal of the institution. And here's the last the access to the last groups. And I have also access here to the database of PDF, manual users manuals, the training, and a formula of contacts to contact interlocutor of Canon. And here I have access to my community. In my community, I can see the group. You can see this is the name, the same name of the group we have seen in the other interface, because this is the same user. I have the same content. This is just a way of showing content and showing functionalities. Here we have access to, I can see all my groups, and I can see groups of Canon on which I'm not already a member. So I can ask access to become a member. So here, all my groups, I can navigate through my groups. And here, I have the possibility to ask to be member of another Canon group. This is groups linked to this institution and not other. If I want to join Mara group standard, I can go by there to search group with the default Mara system. And here I can see my documents. And my documents, I have my pages, page with share with me, my journals, my file. And as the UNES institution, Canon asks us to merge also pages and files. So we will do this modification for them in sooner. We're still working on this institution. And I can see in my community, if I enter on a group, for example, this one. Okay, so I enter in a group, and in a group I can see the dashboard of the group, the forums of the group, page of the group, page share with the group, files of the group, and journals of the group, and access direct to the conference, like a big blue button or something like this, and access to external files, the files of the group, the member, etc. This is usual. And what we have done here, on the dashboard, we have made a place on which the user cannot modify. And the user part of the dashboard is below with the edit button. I have here my dashboard page, own dashboard page. And here, this is the institution dashboard. And what we have done is to merge the standard Mara dashboard page with a page of the institution. This is here a page of the institution. If I go to the edition menu through institution, I have the institution pages here, just to show you the institution was Canon Medical. And here I can see the dashboard. This is the dashboard part. So I can give the possibility to the institution administrator, not the whole site administration, but the institution administrator, to manage this part of the page. They can put what they want, and it will directly affect this part of the dashboard. So this is on this dashboard we are creating this block. This is a plugin type, which show what are the next events with a small formula. And at the last, we have developed also this block, which is by default not accessible for page institution page, but only personal page. So we have made some change at this place. So I've just finished. I have finished my my little tour. it was just to show you some different development we have done, but and the philosophy of how we are using Mahara. It is not really a university way of using, except for UNES, but more private organization and to use it as a social network more bigger.
Wow, that was incredible. And I, looking at the comments, I think everybody else is a little bit in love with your Mahara site. It's absolutely fabulous. So thank you very, very much. There's some good questions as well. Where's it gone? Where's it gone? Somebody asking about your upgrades and how difficult it is to maintain them. Where's the actual question? Oh, yeah, how much of a pain is a new release of Mahara? Is there a lot of manual updating? That's from Andrew Field.
Actually, we are trying to have less than 1 hour late regarding the increase of Mahara version. So we are on 18.04, and our difficulty is, as you see, we have completely rebuilt the way of creating pages, and this is a huge increase of the 18.10 version, and that's why we are not already done the we have not already done the migration to this version. But the way we are working is to just work on plugin and on theme to be able to easily follow the flow of the Mahara community. But sometimes it changes because the version of PHP, the version of CSS, the version or something like this of JavaScript, and on the Smarty, this is Smarty, the engine of the theme engine, and sometimes we need to adapt a little, but no big deal in fact.
Okay, any more questions? I think everyone's just awestruck. People, this looks better than 100 grand solutions. Yeah, everyone's impressed. Okay, well, we'll stop there. We'll move on to the next talk. But